Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Shruti Thakur from University of Delhi. Today we are going to talk on module Diurnal Motions of Stars under the paper Astronomy and Astrophysics. After completing this module, the students will be able to understand why stars and celestial objects describe circular orbits from east to west. Learn that the diurnal circles of stars are in planes parallel to the celestial equator. Explain why some stars are circumpolar for an observer and why some are never visible to the observer. Derive the condition for a star to be circumpolar. Understand that the polar regions of sun is a circumpolar for a part of the year and can be seen even at midnight. In the last three modules, we have dealt with the various coordinate systems for celestial objects. This subject is collectively called as positional astronomy. In particular, we discussed the horizon system, the equatorial systems of both kinds, that is the hour angle declination system and right ascension declination system, the ecliptic system and the galactic system. We also learned the situation where each of these systems is important. Depending on the need of the observer, it is necessary to transform coordinates from one system to another. We saw how this can be done using spherical trigonometry. This module is the last in positional astronomy, where we discuss the motion of star as seen by observers at various locations. We know that the Earth rotates on its axis from west to east, completing one rotation in 24 hours. This is shown in the picture. Seen from above the North Pole, this rotation is anti-clockwise. It is the rotation that is responsible for the phenomena of day and night. Being on Earth, we do not feel this motion. Instead, the celestial objects appears to rotate from east to west, completing one orbit in 24 hours. Since the celestial objects appear to rotate from east to west, completing one orbit in 24 hours, this daily motion of objects is called diurnal motion. While the Earth rotates on its axis from west to east, the stars appears to rotate from east to west in orbits. These orbits are in plane perpendicular to the axis of rotation, parallel to the plane of celestial equator. The path of the stars follow circles which are called as diurnal circles. In the picture, the circles are shown as the diurnal circles of stars. Diurnal circles are in plane parallel to the celestial equator. In both the north as well as the south hemisphere, the stars appear to rotate in same direction from east to west. If we look up, we see stars and other celestial objects rotating clockwise. In this picture, the horizon of an observer is shown. The observer is in the northern hemisphere at some latitude. We know that the celestial objects above the horizon are visible and those objects which are below are not visible. The diurnal circles of stars are also shown in the picture. A part of the diurnal circle which is above the horizon is marked with red, and the part which is below is marked in black. The portion of diurnal circle which is above the horizon, the star is visible during that part of the day. Below the horizon, the star is not visible. When the star crosses the horizon and becomes visible, the star is said to have risen. As long as the star in its diurnal motion is above the horizon, it is visible. When it goes below the horizon, the star is no longer visible. It is said to have set. For some observers, some stars do not cross the horizon at all, which are shown in complete red and black circles in the picture. Those above the horizon are visible all the time. They are called as circumpolar stars because of their proximity to the pole. Those below the horizon are never visible to the observer. The diurnal circles of stars north of celestial equator are more than half above the horizon, whereas the stars in the south of celestial equator have less than half of their diurnal circles above the horizon. Thus, for an observer in the northern latitude, the stars in the north will be visible for longer duration as compared to the stars in the south. Let us now derive the condition for a star to be circumpolar for observer in northern hemisphere. For an observer in northern latitude, there are some stars that never set because they never go below the horizon and they trace complete diurnal circles above the horizon. Such stars are called circumpolar stars. In the picture, an observer is at latitude phi in the northern hemisphere. Therefore, the arc PN equals to phi. We consider a star whose diurnal circle just touches the horizon. So therefore, the declination of this star is the arc RN. As the poles are perpendicular to the equator, therefore PR equals to 90 degree and hence PN equals to 90 minus delta. We also know PN equals to phi. Therefore, 90 minus phi equals to delta is the condition which a star whose diurnal circle just touches the horizon satisfies. Therefore, all the stars whose declination exceeds 90 minus phi are circumpolar to the latitude phi. Therefore, we have obtained the condition for a star to be a circumpolar star at latitude phi in the northern hemisphere. The condition for a star to be never visible from latitude phi is that its declination should be less than phi minus 90. Let us take an example of an observer on equator. For the observer on equator, its latitude is 0. That means the phi is 0. For such an observer, hence, from the above equation, for a star to be circumpolar, the declination should be greater than 90 degree. But we know that the maximum value of declination can be 90 degrees south or north. Hence, there is no circumpolar star for an observer at equator. Let us take another example where the observer is at North Pole. In that case, the latitude of observer is 90 degree. Hence, phi is equal to 90 degree. And from the above equation, the declination of a star should be greater than 0 so as it is visible as a circumpolar star to the observer. This implies that for an observer at North Pole, all the stars above celestial equator are circumpolar and all below equator are never visible. Similarly, for observer in southern hemisphere, we can obtain the condition for a star to be circumpolar. So the condition for a star to be circumpolar at southern latitude is given as the declination should be greater than 90 minus phi. And the condition for a star to be never visible from southern latitude is the declination should be less than phi minus 90 degree. Let us consider an example of constellation Big Bear, which in Hindi is called as Saptarishi. This constellation has 7 stars. This constellation is also shown in the picture. The star which is farthest from the pole has declination of 49 degree. Using the condition of circumpolar stars, which says that the declination of the star should be greater than 90 minus the latitude of the observer. Using this condition, we obtain that the latitude of an observer should be greater than 41 degree for this constellation to be circumpolar. Therefore, these observers, which are at latitude 41 degree or higher, see the Big Bear circling around the pole all the time, except of course when the sun masks them with its brightness. In the second picture, the names of prominent stars of Big Bear and their Indian equivalent names are shown. Stars around the pole star are circumpolar for lower latitudes. They appear to move in circular orbits around the pole star. The photograph shows North Star. Pole star is also called as North Star. The photograph also shows the trails of circumpolar stars in the photograph with a long shutter speed of several hours. For an observer at the North Pole, all stars in northern hemisphere with declination greater than zero are circumpolar. For this observer, stars in southern hemisphere have declination greater than zero. They will never rise. They are always below the horizon. For an observer at South Pole, all the stars in the southern hemisphere which have declination less than zero are circumpolar. For this observer, stars in the northern hemisphere with declination greater than zero never rise. They are always below the horizon. For an observer on the equator, the horizon is perpendicular to it, which is shown in the picture. The horizon divides each diurnal circle in two equal parts, half above the horizon and half below it. All stars in the northern and southern hemisphere are visible to the observer. Half the time these stars are visible, for the other half they are set. Let us now take a look at the motion of the sun. Sun, being the nearest star, also has diurnal circles, which is why every day we see the sun rising and setting. Now we know this is not because the sun is moving, it is because of the rotation of the earth on its axis. The earth is also revolving around the sun, and it takes 1 year for earth to complete one revolution. We on earth do not feel this motion, and it appears as if the sun is going around the earth. This apparent path is called the ecliptic. The projection of ecliptic on celestial sphere makes an angle of 23 degrees and 27 minutes with the equator. Sun takes 365 days to go around the earth. This implies that it takes around 365 days to make a round trip of 360 degrees. This also implies that the sun is moving at the rate of 1 degree per day. Since the earth is moving, it means that the coordinates, right ascension and declination of sun is changing continuously. In the picture, the brown circle is the celestial equator. At position E of the ecliptic, sun is in the north of equator. At this position, the coordinates of sun are right ascension 6 hours and declination 23.5 degrees. Sun happens to be at this location on 21st of June, which is also called as summer solstice. The motion of sun is anti-clockwise. After 21st of June, sun heads towards the south. This is the beginning of Dakshinayan, but it is still in the north of equator. On 23rd of September, the celestial equator and the ecliptic intersects. At this position, the coordinates of the sun are right ascension 12 hours and declination 0. This is called as the autumn equinox. Sun is in the south now. At position W, sun is in the south of celestial equator. At this position, the coordinates of sun are right ascension 18 hours and declination minus 23.5 degrees. This is the location of sun on 22nd of December. This is called as the winter solstice. This position marks the beginning of Uttarayan as the northward journey of sun stars. On 21st of March, the sun is at celestial equator. This position of sun is called as vernal equinox. This is shown as the sign of Aries in the picture. At this position, the coordinates of sun are right ascension 0 and declination 0. This is because we take this position as a reference point in the equatorial system of right ascension and declination. Therefore, the right ascension is 0 for sun at this position. Between 21st March and 23 September, the declination of sun is between 0 degree and 23.5 degrees. For these 6 months, the sun is circumpolar for latitudes greater than 66.5 degrees. For observer in these locations, the sun never sets during the 6 months. It is visible even at midnight, which is shown in the picture. During the remaining 6 months, the sun never rises for these observers. For the observers in the southern polar region, the sun remains above the horizon for 6 months from 23rd September to 21st March, because the declination of sun is between 0 and 23.5 degrees south. For them, the sun is set for 6 months from 21st March to 23rd September. So students, let us now summarize what we have learned in this module. The earth on its axis rotates from west to east. As seen from above the north pole, this motion is anti-clockwise. We on Earth see all celestial objects moving from east to west in circular orbits. The plane of these orbits are parallel to the celestial equator. If the orbit of a star crosses the horizon of the observer, this star too The star is visible when above the horizon, and it is invisible as it goes below the horizon. When a star just comes up the horizon, it is said to have risen. The moment it goes below the horizon, it is said to have set. If the orbit of a star is always above the horizon, the star is always visible and is called as circumpolar star. If the orbit is completely below the horizon, the star is never visible to the observer. Whether a star is circumpolar or not depends on the latitude of the observer also. For an observer on North Pole, all the stars in the northern hemisphere are circumpolar and all those in the southern hemisphere are not visible. For an observer on the South Pole, all the stars in the southern hemisphere are circumpolar and all the stars on the northern hemisphere are not visible. In the polar region, the sun rises and sets for 6 months at a stretch. Sun can be seen even at midnight at these places. An observer at the equator can see all the stars from both the hemisphere, but only for half the time because the horizon divides the orbits of stars in two equal halves. Thank you.